Becoming a Doctor of Sales. Let me tell you about this blog today because it is all about getting a PhD in results. And if you're a sales professional, you might not get a certificate that says you went to school for 8 years and you're the best of the best, but you do get a really big paycheck when you get a PhD in results, which means you have become a doctor of selling. Now, I will tell you, if you go to see a doctor, they do three things. You first go in, they do an examination. You got to know what the problem is. Then they give you a diagnosis based on their examination. And then of course, they give you a prescription for your pain. But what do most salespeople do? They prescribe, buy from me. But they don't actually win those sales because it's called the hard, easy approach, which means you do the hard work up front. You find out what's really going on, what's in it for them. Because Dale Carnegie said the only way to influence someone is to talk about what they want and show them how to get it. Now, a doctor might see someone's having a different problem than what they think, but you have to listen to the patient. You have to listen to the prospect. You have to know where they're coming from. And in order to influence them or even be able to tell people what your products and services are, you got to know whether or not it's a really good fit. And that's why we have to ask these questions. I'm a big fan of salespeople being able to take their game to the next level and fine-tuning their skills. But you all know that I'm a Bible girl and I love the Bible. And it says here in Proverbs 13:20, he who walks with wise men will be wise, but the companion of fools will suffer harm. So who are we spending time with? Are we spending time with the doctors in our field? And really, school's never out for the pro. So are we out there fine-tuning our skill sets? Because satisfaction is an emotion that leads to depression. So if you're satisfied with your results, that means you need to kind of rev the engines up again and we need to make some shifts. And, Christopher Reeve said something powerful and he said, pain is inevitable, but misery is an option. And so I think, with the pandemic going on, we have to adapt and change our processes, but we don't have to be miserable about it. I mean, it is what it is. I'm talking to you over video. I'd rather see you in person for a cup of coffee or in a large setting speaking to a group, but we have to adapt. And so it's a little painful. It's not as fun, but we have to adapt and we have to make some changes. So think about what changes that you need to make in order to up your game, and let's take our sales skills to the next level.